But don't forget, together, what are we looking for in a standard walk? What do you think?
Well, you want his neck lengthened out.
Yes, what else?
Put his nose out a little bit.
A little bit, yeah, what else? What's one of the main things? What does the judge look for? You know? Overstep. Overstep. Supplements of the back, okay? So just be sure, don't forget when you school, the walk is very important. So if we kind of think, oh well, I'm not worried about the walk, I'll just, then we get in trouble. So follow, 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 with the front legs. Follow there, follow. So if he starts using neck and back like that, then you're closer to a seven. He has some overstep, but if he's not stretching through the neck and back, then you're closer to a six and a seven, which we don't have. So don't, just have it be a part of your daily routine. Yeah? Follow, follow, follow. So when they're truly connected, as we follow, they seek the bit. It's okay, close your fingers when he pops up and then follow again. That's right, good boy. In short, he's riding some very nice horse. You two look great together.
Thank you.
This is, fabulous. Thank you. I'm wonderful.
And then trot. We're not gonna do a lot more, we're about done, but I just wanna do just a teeny bit more. Bend him right, circle down here. A little more right bending. Flex him to the right. There. There. There you go. Good boy. There. Good boy. Good. And short diagonal medium. That's all right. Now bring him back. How about that seat? That's the seat we want to have. Bring it back. Circle in that scary corner. Canter left. Canter down the center line. Hold it X. We're just trying to have him understand the center line pretty soon. He's going to want to start to understand that he could. Not yet. He's going to be able to canter down the center line. It doesn't really change. Are you sure? I'm sure it does. Just change back. Change back. That's right. Good. Now just ride straight. Tell him he's okay. See, look, it's not that big a deal. You don't have to do this for a little while. Change back. Just hold it. Just too excited. Ooh. And circle. So you're not going to make a big deal out of it, but what it tells you is when you go to ride the shoulder four on the center line in the place where he's not quite used to cantering, right? It confuses him.
Yeah.
You just say, well, okay. Ride a little medium canter on the long side. So we don't get after the horse. We just say, oh, I see. You're not quite sure about being, doesn't matter. Fix it. There you go. Come down the center line. Talk to him. Say, look, it's okay. You're making a much bigger deal out of this than it is. Yeah. Say, real quiet. Real quiet. And hold. Whoa. Whoa. And stand. Whoa. Now pet him. Nice hold. Good boy. So, you have to be careful. We introduce something new and we're like,
I'll follow him in.
It's like, but it's okay. Just say, well, we'll have to work this out. Bend him right. Well, that wasn't quite what I had in mind. Bend him right. So we keep sending, for a sensitive horse, we keep sending a positive message. Bend him right. So here's what I want. Yeah, shorten your right leg. Walk and here. So you just, when you notice that something comes up where you're thinking, this isn't quite what I wanted, just repeat it. Same way, we're not going to make a big deal out of it, but we're going to repeat it until you understand. Move them off the right leg, bend them right, bend them right. Yeah, they can't come above the bit if they're flexed or positioned there. Good. Keep them flexed. And look, sorry, you have to do it. Just a little bit. Yeah, and so remember, the outside leg is a signal. If the horse is sensitive and the haunches wing in, less outside leg or don't move it so far. Now get him a little bit rounder. Say, come on, you're okay. And canter. Yeah, okay. Popped up a little bit, but was straighter.
So I want you to pan around a circle. We're going to do it one more time.
Darn it! I thought we were done. That was really good. Bend them right. Keep them supple. Now, leg yield them a little bit off that right leg. Just say, look, you're not in trouble. I'm not mad at you. You're fine. You just need to let me set you up. There you go. There you go. Good. And Tanner, when you're ready, keep your contacts. So don't get mad at me. You're all right. Good, good. Keep that left hand a little bit down, just a little bit. I know it makes your arm straight, but the idea is that you keep that contact. Yeah, keep the contact. Move the bed a little bit, so don't get upset. You're not in trouble. It's not a pass-fail. Yeah. Yep. That was much better, wasn't it? Good boy. Tell him he's good. So that they're very clear. Oh, I'm so happy with you. Yay. So if we stop repeating it, they should know that's what we want. That's right. And then turn down your next low quarter line. You'll hit the rail short of the right rein. Just let you close your fingers on the left. Say, look, come on. A little rounder. Darn it. And over. Over. Good boy. That's a good boy. And somewhere do a 10-meter circle. And then half pass right. Good. Yeah, not faster. Back right. Yeah, one more time. Fine. Good boy. Short the right rein. So if your hand is getting close to the saddle, the rein's too long. It's pretty clear. And half pass, turn his nose right. Good. A little bit rounder, not faster. There. Track to the right. Oh, it's just a little bit. There you go. You can set it. Short diagonal, fine change. On the bit. On the bit. Yeah. So, change itself was a solid 7. You just want to be careful. If he's a little bit tight or if you've got the head tilt after the change, that might take half a point off circle. Okay? So you just start to really realize that they're teaching us to be much more thorough. It's not just, it changes the essence, of course, but it's also everything else, the connection, the quality of the canopy before and after the change. And then after your circle, set him up for half pass left. And change the, there you go, change the flexion a little bit. So one head tilt, just so you know, just it's a little bit of a lack of suppleness or firmness, and but it takes half a point off on whatever the movement is, unless it's a really severe head tilt. It'll take a full point off. There you go. So what's nice about half pass is that there, you see the head tilt's gone. Good for you. Track left, do that one more time. Very nice horse. This is it. I'm fabulous. Yeah. And it's interesting now. In the half pass, the hind legs come together, but a lot of times the hind legs are a little sprouted. That's probably from when the back was not developed.
Mm-hmm.
And short turn angle, one check. Not getting pretty high. Okay, that's fine. Very good. Good boy. And then next long side, a little medium canter. And then when you're schooling, it's hard when we're all sitting here, I know, but when you're schooling, it's hard too because those two corners are filled, but just remind yourself, as your training progresses, try to ride these corners a little bit deeper, okay? Because either the corners in the short end are an opportunity or an afterthought. And if they're an afterthought, later on you think, oh, I could have used those corners to set my horse up. And then canter on the center line, hold to that. A little bit more of a shoulder forward here.
doesn't matter. Just say, don't get mad at me. Don't get mad at me. Put your left hand down. Doesn't matter. Just regroup. He went, oh my God, whatever's in the corner almost got me. Oh. Look for the center line. Yeah, she'll be out of the line. There you go. Good. Now rocking back. Doesn't matter. Did that on purpose. So when you have one that offers changes when you go to straighten them, right in. It's a lovely position. Just, thank you, I've worked hard on this.
Mm-hmm.
There you go. Okay, next long side. Shorten the reins a little bit. And pass E a 10 meter circle. Keep your left leg just a little bit back and closer, just a little bit. Don't let the haunches swing out. That became a little teardrop shape. Did you feel it? Do another one here at C. We don't, oftentimes, you know, unless we're getting ready for a show, I don't know about you, but a lot of my students don't do enough circles. I'm like, for God's sake, the circle's your friend. Use the circle. There you go. That was much better. Good. And then next long side shoulder in. A little bit, just slightly rounder. See how the inside rein's a little against the neck? Take the right rein just slightly off the neck. The angle is kept from your upper body, your weight coming back, and your inside leg. Inside rein does very little. Again, shoulder in. Keep your left leg a little back, you're a little braced there. That's right. You can come back without him getting confused about what it is. Be careful he doesn't train you, look at me, to put the inside leg forward in the shoulder in. Okay? One more time. Just keep the left leg back and steady. And it's just not unfair when they're so supple and young and you tell them to do it, they just do it. Like, oh, there you go. Doesn't matter. Careful. Not too much pressure. Because, oh, you're in trouble. You're in trouble. And then shoulder in, 10 meter circle, haunches in. Very nice horse.
She did good.
Your left leg close. Doesn't have to be a 10 meter circle, make it round. So look at the origin, make sure it doesn't start to fall in. And haunches in. A little more angle. Yeah, look in the mirror. There, and straight before the corner. And then next long side, half pass from the rail to the center line, but take time to get there. Watch the haunches don't swing out in the corners. Yeah, over. Shorten your right rein a little bit. Turn his nose right. Now it's not a hind end issue. I know it feels like it, but it's not that there's a lack of activity. Track right. It's that he just needed to be just a little bit more positioned right with the shoulders leading. So when you ride a half pass, lead the shoulder. Then think about the bend in the body and halfway. Then make sure near the end the haunches aren't trailing. There you go. And straight, track left. Good boy. And make a 20 meter circle. And shorten the left rein a little bit. There you go. Flex him a little left. Yeah. A little softer. There you go. Good boy. There you go. And then the head tilt's gone. And then, of course, it'll come back if I say that. Shoulder in left. Very nice horse.
Good worker.
Yeah. Okay. Because those scarrow corners are really scary. Oh, it almost got me. What was that? You know what they don't like? It's funny how you can think like a horse. They don't like if the sand hits the blocks.
Yeah, it's really noisy.
Blue and white. But also, when the sand hits the blocks, they don't like that. That's it. There you go. And straighten. That was much better. Next long side shoulder in, 10 meter circle, haunches in towards the scary blocks. And I want you to just try to just remind yourself, when they understand the exercise, the opposite leg helps to maintain the correct bend. If it comes off, then we're not really getting that nose to tail bending. So once they understand an exercise, the opposite leg, more angle. More angle. There, like that. That's suppling. Straighten and pat him. Oh my God, where's this boy? next corner half past the center line, a little bit rounder. Because I'm here, it's all about me. That was a little wide. It's about 11 meters. Do it again. Make it 10. That's right. Has a gymnastic effect if it's more accurate. And then half pass. Not rushing. Yeah. There. Yeah. Easier to the left, huh? Good boy. Good. And straight ahead. And walk. Right. Stay on the contact. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3. Yeah, 1, 2, 3. Well, okay, now let the reins out. Let them relax a little bit. Okay, that's interesting. That was very interesting because he was fine until she went to lengthen the reins. Well, let him go to the buckle. There you go. Scratch his neck a little bit. Say, look, I can loosen the reins. It's okay. So here's the good news. Good news is, on a contact, the rhythm to me looked fine. When you went to loosen the reins, he started to get a little funny in the shoulders. All right. So, what can I tell you? Just go back and forth. Longer reins, shorter reins. Longer reins, shorter reins.
Thank you. So, yes, I know.
The blacks and the bays are really.
Can you see how? There you go. The inside leg is close. There. Okay, now half turn, half hold on your outside rein. That's it. Now half pass back. That's actually your best one. Turn his nose. There you go. Good. And do it to the left. Half pass left. Shorten the left rein. Get him soft from the left rein. There. Sit more left. Scoot your there. Good. Now turn around, look at his left hip, and turn around it. Take the left hand left, way to the side. It's okay, tell him it's okay, he's not in trouble. And half pass. So we're not trying to upset him, but we're trying to have him up. There you go. Good. Good boy, pet him. Good, okay, that's enough of that. I just want you to have it on video, because that will really help you to start to understand about the shoulder control. You just have to